recognizes Representative Oakes.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise in opposition of House Bill 5125. The bill would result in the elimination of a much-needed judgeship in the 70th District Court in Saginaw. The most recent State Court Administrator's Office Judicial Resources recommendations calls for the elimination of one of six district judgeships in the 70th District. According to SCAO, Saginaw is 2.45 in excess of judges. Not quite sure how they came to the determination of 2.45. With all due respect, I disagree with SCAO's assessment. I disagree with the incomplete picture it has painted of what is really happening in Saginaw. I challenge SCAO to spend a day in the shoes of the court system of Saginaw. Saginaw has one of the busiest court systems in the state. And I question, did SCAO take into consideration that Saginaw is ranked number 3 in the nation by the most recent FBI statistics for violent crime? How could SCAO forget that Governor Snyder labeled Saginaw as one of the 4 crime-ridden cities, so much that he focused much of his efforts on pointing that out, along with the city of Detroit and others? Does SCAO know that for the past few years, violent crime has escalated in Saginaw at a record pace? Do they know that as a result of Saginaw's district court, we have had district court judges having an overloaded caseload, helping out the circuit court judges? Does SCAO know that circuit court judges, on average, have been trying cases in the circuit court more than the other 83 counties over the past 3 years? Did SCAO take into consideration that one of our judges had to be assigned exclusively to handling business court issues as mandated by this body? Does SCAO know how much time our judges devote to specialty courts in addition to the basic functions that they are statutorily required to do? While we applaud the life-changing benefits that participants and experience and our judges have devoted a considerable amount of time to operating these courts, we must recognize that we cannot apply a cookie-cutter method to the court system, much like we can't apply it to the classroom. Has SCAO thought about the impact a reduction in judicial resources we will have on citizens in Saginaw? Will justice be served swiftly to victims? Or will their justice be delayed or denied completely because the court will have unacceptable backlogs? How safe will our citizens be when our court system is overburdened and thus ineffective? I cannot answer any of these questions. Only SCAO can. I can only tell you that SCAO has offered no answers and no compelling arguments for eliminating a district court judgeship in Saginaw County. We have proactively done what we can in the face of losing a magistrate with a unfilled judgeship and in these challenging financial times. So to you, Mr. Speaker, Counselor, Esquire, the citizens of Saginaw County deserve more, which is why I urge you to vote no on this bill. Thank you.
Thank you, Representative Oakes. The question before the House is on the final passage of the bill. A record roll call vote is required. The clerk will open the board.